All right, troops, welcome back. Today we're gonna finish up our oil pan installation. We went ahead and did our rear main seal last night, put the RTV on, put the new seals in, put the bearing cap back into place, torqued everything back down, put the girdle in place, torqued that back down. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is clean up the inside of the oil pan. You wanna make sure the edges where the new gasket are going to go are really clean. So we're going to go ahead and clean this surface area up a little bit. All we're going to utilize is some basically Scotch-Brite and some engine degreaser to make sure that this is very clean. And then we'll do a final wipe with some acetone. We already cleaned the bottom side of the block for the mating surface on that, just for the fact you want to make sure it's very clean, no impurities. Make sure there's no oil or grease on there or the gasket won't have a chance. So let's go ahead and get started. And before we do the final installation, we'll make sure there's nothing down in the pan in the lower parts. So we'll clean everything else up. The part number we're using for the oil pan gasket, it's a Felpro. It's a OS, as an October Sierra 34308 Romeo. What we have with that is you have this fancy one-piece gasket now, rather than the multi-piece. Basically, for the, you'd have the old school rails on either side of the pan, then you have another gasket up here in the front. It's pretty ingenious. This is a really good design. I have another one of these I need to do on my 96 Cherokee, so I'm really anxious to see how well this holds up. The other thing too that it comes with is it comes with these snap-ups. What these do is these actually screw in to the bottom of the block on all four corners, you know, two in the back, two in the front, and that gives you the chance to put the gasket in place, and then you can put the oil pan up in place without having to fight it underneath. So that's also a very unique design. It definitely is beneficial and will help with the installation. So let's go ahead and get started here. Be able to tell, but there's actually some old, looks like RTV, possibly old gasket left on here. So we're just going to go ahead and take our razor blade. Thank you. progress. So take. So I think we're pretty good. Go ahead and we'll do a final wipe with some acetone, get rid of the degreaser, and put some RTV on the corners. Now with that, the gasket is going to lay in here. So what we'll do is we'll put just a little bit of RTV on the bottom here, and then we'll put a little bit of RTV on the top of the gasket. That way when it bolts up, we have good adhesion and hopefully a good gasketing surface. It should hopefully minimize any potential future leaks. Also, at the front, what you have is from here, from this hole back, is all engine block. Up here, this is where your timing cover sits. So your timing cover meets the block. You're going to want to put some RTV on both sides, left and right. That way you have a good good seal there as well. Just for the fact that you have two different metals, they expand and contract differently. And they'll never seal right, so we're going to go ahead and put some RTV there on there as well. And other than that, I think we're in good shape. So let's go ahead and do a final wipe down and slam this thing in.